In times of change, things can get super duper confusing, super duper complex. Especially when it comes to communication and showing our people the way, we need to be super crystal clear on what we mean. I am no smart cookie. I've learned this the very hard way, I promise you. Because, I mean, in my 10 plus years of assisting people and companies in their innovation processes, buzzword, I often stepped into the trap of throwing around buzzwords like innovation, as I said, design thinking, iteration, input, warm up, change, transformation. Very soon, having everyone around snoozing off, busy with their phones, or just like, I don't know if you ever seen this empty look on people's face. And I was like, man, they don't get it. No, the truth is I wasn't clearly communicating what I meant. And that's why I wanted to do this video for you, so you can become super clear on what you want. And as we know, in order to create a future, we need everyone on board and their full power. But if we throw buzzwords around like change and transformation, where we think everyone knows, but without knowing clearly what we mean, or we can't communicate, we can't inspire, and we won't succeed. So with this new innovation session, I'd like to help you clear up this association definition mess of what is change and what is transformation, to be able to communicate effectively, take action, and lead your people through these challenging times. Welcome to a new episode of Hedy's Innovation Gym with change versus transformation. What's the difference? Get clear and communicate effectively. Another buzzword jungle edition. By the way, before we start, if you're new to this channel, this is all about innovation topics like design thinking, tools, mindset, and strategy. Subscribe if that sounds interesting and hit the bell to get notified each time I post a new innovation session every Tuesday. Okay, let's start. What is change? What is transformation? And what are common associations? In terms of official dictionary definitions, they are pretty similar. Change is, according to just a regular dictionary, a process of alteration, yes, also transformation, substitution, menopause? Okay, whereas transformation is defined as leaving the status quo and building anew. Okay, sounds similar? Especially change being identified as a form of transformation. But when we look at the word substitution, this is what change, I believe, is oftentimes associated with, and therefore there is a major difference. So to my experience, when people hear change, they often hear substitution. Everything will be substituted. Nothing I've done in the past will be of relevance. Therefore, they have little to zero motivation even before the process has begun. And that is a big issue because, of course, you need your people to be motivated and to be on board. So do you really mean substitution? Do you mean change, which means fixing things, fixing processes, methods that were put in place in the past and need to be renewed? That's change in business terms. Or do you want to create a new future based on a new company or team culture, a new strategy with different values and beliefs? So a more future-oriented, holistic, strategic approach. Transformation, transformation, transformation. It is. So what do you mean? What do you want to go for? More holistic, long-term, or fixing things in the now, short term? Now, for taking action, if you go for change, that would probably mean that you will need to do quite a bit of monitoring and controlling, because you need to know if that change process, the new processes, for example, I don't know, design thinking, check out my other video here on design thinking, you've put into place the new methods, for example, customer journey mapping, you are applying, if they're working. Now, if you're going for the transformation approach, however, not so much. You for sure should have your KPIs, your key performance indicators, gosh, so you can measure the results. But since it's a strategic approach based on your company's identity, these KPIs are based on the question, do we live this strategy? Like, are we really moving towards our vision of being For example, the most customer-centric organization in the whole wide world. This is such a different mindset because when you talk transformation, it's really more like, okay, as long as the method or the process is serving our strategy, our vision, our purpose, and who we are serving, our customer, this is fine. And you can much easier totally adapt according to what is needed. Whereas when you think change, the focus is really more on, as I said, fixing things in the past to be productive in the present. So again, what is it? What do you mean? And what do you want to go for? Change or transformation? Let me know in the comment section below. This is the last part of the session, and this is very, very important. Whatever it is, make sure you use a word or a claim that has a positive or at least a neutral image in your company or a team. Or simply rename the whole thing. And be as descriptive as possible so people buy into it, they can talk about it easier and are motivated to go on that journey with you. For example, as I said, if your people have already experienced 10 change processes over the last years, it's probably not a good idea to say this word another 11th time. And maybe also transformation is a word that brings about question marks. For example, I give you an example. I was once assisting a transformation process, and whenever the CEO would mention that term transformation process, everyone was looking at each other like they were really fun, giggling. And then I asked them, okay, what was the association? And you know what they thought about? The movie Transformers, the action movie. And they literally envisioned some envisioned that they were replaced by superhumans, and the others thought they were supposed to become superhumans in the process. Either way, this was not what the CEO intended, and really best is to check what the image is. Or as I said, help them understand by finding another title, something unique, not an empty marketing slogan. Something that helps to connect and to communicate your plan. Like, I don't know, something descriptive, like the agenda, customer is king 2022. Something motivational for your people and giving direction and purpose. Because if you're saying customer is king 2020, we all know it's about making our customer happy by 2020, and it's way more concrete than just transformation or change, right? I hope so. 1, 2, 3, change versus transformation. I hope this was of benefit to you. If so, like and subscribe and check out my other innovation sessions. Also pass this on to people who need to see this in these turbulent times. And thanks so much for your time and your energy. See you in the next innovation session. I can't wait. Bye-bye.